I realized that in our community, especially Pakistan, we have been deprived of our classical arts. It is a subject which requires a lot of patience, a lot of intelligence, not intellect, intelligence, and a lot of heart. Well, that ever since I was a child, I was much interested in painting and drawing and then dancing and singing. And I did all of those things. Even though I was studying in the academic schools and doing my O levels and A levels in science, but my passion was the arts. And it was only after I was doing my graphic designing in the Department of Fine Arts that I discovered classical dance. So I started learning that from my teacher, Ghulam Hussain Kathak. And having learned that, I was also interested in singing as well. But he sort of discouraged me that these are both classical arts and it's very difficult even to master one classical art, let alone two. But I was very obstinate as a person. He gave me teacher's training in Kathak because I belonged to a family who was not favorable, you know, towards me performing on public stages. After I started, the school next door sort of pulled me in. They said, "You're wasting your time in the house with my children." I had my little four children, and they said, "You come and you teach dance." And that's how my dancing career as a teacher started. After a few years, I also was still hankering after music, singing. So I started learning singing. Actually, I got the teacher for my children, and they got up and they left. You know, they got bored singing, you know, doing the classical stuff. And I sat down and I said, "Okay, now I will learn it." And I think I've been very lucky to have been able to study and to learn what I was really passionate about. The real excitement of my life, if I look back at it, was learning all these different things. I realized that in our community, especially Pakistan, we have been deprived of our classical arts because somehow they got attached to a taboo or a unfavorable, you know, activity. Now, there's a history behind it. I don't want to touch on the history, but nevertheless, even when I was learning dance, it was looked down upon. Oh, she's learning dance, you know. But I, because it was my passion, I went ahead and I did it, regardless of what my extended family was talking about, you know, or saying about it. And I used to get a lot of criticism, but I think it made me stronger. What I decided then, about 40 odd years ago, was that I would like to preserve my culture and heritage. And I, because I've been a student myself, I've learned these things myself, I've been teaching them. I said I found out while doing the classical arts that the classical art is a very, very deep subject. It is a subject which requires a lot of patience, a lot of intelligence, not intellect, intelligence, and a lot of heart. So you get all these elements put together in under one roof. The heart, the intelligence, and the persistence. And that is the making of the human being. So if we are to talk about humanity, every person on earth needs to study some classical art. I say that. Not everyone will agree with me, but I'm telling you through experience that I discovered myself through my arts. And the love which goes behind it, the depth of that art is so, it's so humongous that once you start entering it, it's like you enter into a new world, into a new dimension. And I'm sure the scientists will also say that science is a huge, huge subject. Very good. I feel any subject, I'm not only talking classical arts, I'm so talking for Pakistan because Pakistanis are not appreciative of the classical arts. But they need to know how much learning there is in it for them. In the West, there has been research on the cerebral, the left and the right cerebrums of the brain and how one is the logical and the other one is the creative. I think over here, the education has nothing to do with the creative side of the brain. It is all logical. We need to have the creative side in us because we are co-creators with this nature. We are co-creators. Hey,